Hi, everyone. Hey, my name is Kari Thompson. I've got a real special guest for you this afternoon. The word on the street is APL Go. If you've heard the name, it's because it's circulating. We're in Whisper Launch right now. And it's a very, very unique company. We have a very special guest tonight. I'm going to be interviewing Sergey Kulikov. He is the owner of APL Go. A little bit about the company before we actually get into the interview. APL is a 8.5-year-old company out of Eastern Europe. They've done hundreds of millions of dollars in volume, and they're now expanding into the United States. We just started our Whisper launch on July the 7th. And from the United States, we're going to stage into Israel. We're going to stage into Australia, Mexico, and Western Europe. So a really exciting time. So again, if you've heard the rumors on the street about a new company, you're going to want to pay attention. We're going to have a lot of fun with this interview. A couple of things I want to share before we actually get into the interview to continue. APL Go is a U.S.-based company, okay? The owners live in Florida. And one of the things that really impressed me about this company was when I took a look at the website, I noticed that they had a lot of care in their wording, which means to me that they hired a good compliance attorney to look over all of the material. And to me, guys, that's really important. I've been involved in network marketing full-time for about 22 years. I've been a member of a lot of corporate teams, also a top field leader. And you can tell a lot about companies by looking at their claims. Do they know what they're doing? Do they have attorneys? Have they paid the right people to tell the right story? And these guys certainly have. The second thing that I was super excited about was the branding. The branding on the products are absolutely beautiful. Third is the product line. We're going to talk about a product line that's very unique. It's a first-to-market category product line here in the United States and all around the world. Of course, another thing to talk about is the compensation plan. APL Go's compensation plan is very, very unique. I've never seen anything like it. And I think when you take a look at it, we'll talk a little bit about it tonight. I think you'll agree. And most important thing I love about Sergey is his personality. Here's a man who loves network marketing. He's an owner who likes people. And he really shows in his attitude and how he runs his business. So that being said, I'm going to bring on Sergey. Sergey, if you could join us. We'll get you on. Hey, Sergey, how are you doing?
Приветствую, Каури. Я очень рад быть сегодня вместе с тобой здесь на этом интервью.
Welcome, Каури. I'm really happy to be here on the interview right now.
Я так же, как и ты, взволнован от всего происходящего здесь на американском рынке.
I'm excited as well as you launching on this American market.
Я понимаю, что сейчас мы на стадии медленного, тихого старта.
I understand that we are right now at the Whisper launch here.
Но это огромные возможности для больших лидеров, которые уже наверняка обращают внимание на APL.
But it is a huge opportunity for great leaders who pay attention to the company.
Я буду предельно честен в ответах.
I will be honest in my answers.
Поэтому ты можешь задавать абсолютно любые вопросы, я отвечу на все.
So you can ask me any questions, I will answer them.
Я уже взволнован и в ожидании.
I'm really excited and I really wait for it.
Fantastic. Or Sergey, thank you for being my guest this afternoon. We're very excited to have you. As a network marketer, somebody who's been involved in the industry for a long time, I always ask the same questions when I meet owners. So thank you for being up front. Thank you for agreeing to this interview. We're going to get right to it. I've got a couple of questions. Let's start with number one. Why network marketing? Why do you like this industry? How did you get introduced to this business?
О, это очень интересный вопрос.
Well, it is a really interesting question.
Прежде чем я начну отвечать, я бы хотел сказать, что, к сожалению, не владею английским.
And before I start, I would like to tell that I do not speak English.
Моим голосом будет мой персональный ассистент Анна.
My voice is my personal assistant Anna.
Итак, переходя к ответу на вопрос.
So, if you allow me to answer the question.
Это было 15 лет назад.
It was 15 years ago.
Мне было на тот момент 17 лет, и я впервые познакомился с этой индустрией.
I was 17 years old, and it was for the first time when I get acquainted with the network marketing.
Попал я на презентацию очень банально, очень случайно.
And how did I get on the presentation? actually, the story was pretty simple.
Дело в том, что мой дядя, один наш родственник,
my uncle, one of our relatives,
пришел пригласить мою маму на какую-то презентацию.
He came to invite my mom to visit some kind of presentation.
Я думал, что что-то здесь не то. По-моему, какая-то секта.
I thought there must be something wrong. I thought it was something like religious cult or sect.
Я думаю, я пойду и разберусь.
And I thought I need to go and to find out what it is.
Так я попал на презентацию компании, где рисовали кружочки.
That's how I went to the presentation when people draw circles.
С этой презентации, в кавычках, секты, я пришел просто воодушевленный.
So, when I came back home from this presentation, religious cult, as I thought,
I was
really excited.
Я понял, что это супервозможность.
I understood that it is a huge opportunity.
Когда ты делишься с людьми то, чем тебе нравится,
when you share things which you like with people,
я понял, что это реально лучшая индустрия в мире.
I realized that this industry is the best in the world.
So it sounds like you joined as a distributor, is that correct?
Да, я, конечно же, в 17 лет начал свою карьеру с дистрибьютора.
Yes, you are right. When I was 17, I started my career as an associate.
So what did you like about that process of being a distributor? And let's get into the next question. Why would you start your own company later on?
Okay, на самом деле это все взаимосвязано.
Actually, all these things combine.
В сетевом бизнесе мне понравилось отношение.
In network marketing, I really liked the relationship.
Мне понравилась возможность общаться с огромным количеством людей.
I liked the opportunity to interact with a lot of people all over the world.
Мне понравился сам бизнес и сама бизнес-модель.
I loved the business, I loved the business model.
Потому что, помогая другим становиться лучше, ты становишься сам при этом лучше.
Because when you help others to become better, you yourself become better.
Fantastic. I think that's a reason why a lot of us get involved in the industry. So, okay. Sergey, you came on as a distributor, but obviously you started APL many, many years ago. Why did you start your own network marketing company? And this is not an easy thing to do, so maybe talk about that process.
О, да, это действительно далеко не легкая задача.
Oh, yes, it's really difficult to start up a company.
Если отмотать время назад и посмотреть на 8,5 лет назад.
So, if you rewind to the past and take a look what was 8 years ago.
Я думал, что будет все гораздо проще.
I thought this process will be much easier.
Но что, прежде чем я отвечу на вопрос, почему я открыл компанию,
and before I answer the question, why I started my own company,
тут важно понять, что произошло в той предыдущей компании.
It is really important to understand what happened in my previous company where I worked.
В той компании, куда я пришел в 17 лет,
this company which I joined when I was 17,
я был ровно 8 месяцев.
I worked for 8 months.
Я за короткий период сделал промоушен на поездку в Китай.
It took me a few very short period of time to complete the promotion to go to China.
Чтобы посмотреть, как производится продукция.
To see how the product is produced.
И поехав на завод,
and when I went to the factory,
я понял одну большую истину.
I understood one really important thing.
Все, что рассказывается на презентации, это ложь.
Everything you are told during the presentation is a huge lie.
Эта компания закупала продукцию в Китае и перепродавала через сеть в России и в СНГ.
This company where I worked, it bought the product from the factory in China and resold it in Russia.
Когда я это осознал, я понял, что не хочу иметь ничего с этой компанией.
When I found it out, I understood that I do not want to get involved anymore with this company.
Я ушел.
So I left.
Я познакомился с американским проектом.
So, at that time, I get acquainted with an American project.
За полтора года я построил организацию 11 тысяч человек.
It took me 1 year and a half to build the team of 11,000 people.
И тоже ушел из этой компании.
And then I left this company as well.
Потому что компания, в которую я поверил,
because the company I believed in,
там были большие, великие имена в индустрии.
This company had the huge names in their team in the network marketing industry.
И ее продали.
And this company was sold.
Продали вместе с людьми.
This company was sold with people.
Я тоже хочу взять себе небольшое интервью. Как много компаний в Америке и в Европе продается?
So I would like to interview you, Kauri, as well. How many companies in America are sold?
Too many are sold. In fact, Sergey, you bring up a really painful point. When you put your heart and soul into a business and they make bad decisions and sell the company, you really lose your company. So I can understand why you would leave the company.
Вы построили свою
да.
компанию.
Именно поэтому я ушел из той компании.
You are right. That's why I left the previous company.
Потому что все, во что я верил, было разрушено этой продажей.
Because everything I believed in was ruined by this company.
Поэтому я пообещал себе в первую очередь.
So that's why I promised to myself firstly.
Создать такую компанию, которой бы каждый дистрибьютор гордился и был уверен в завтрашнем дне.
To create the company in which each distributor would believe and would know that the future awaits a great one future.
Я ушел в 20 лет из той компании.
I left this company when I was 20.
И только в 24 я создал компанию.
And when I was 24, I opened up my own company.
Отвечая на вопрос твой, Каури.
To answer your question, Каури.
Я могу сказать, что создание компании APL это своего рода вызов.
So when I created, when I opened my own country, it was a challenge for me.
Вызов всей индустрии и всем тем недостойным руководителям.
Challenge for the whole industry and to all those executives in this network marketing industry.
Чтобы создать компанию для людей, наверное, впервые.
To open the company for people for the very first time.
Не хочу делать много рекламы, но за 8 лет это все доказывает то, что мы действительно смогли это сделать.
So I do not want to make a lot of advertising, but what we did proves what great job we did.
I absolutely agree. They've done a wonderful job. Starting a company, Sergey, as you mentioned, is very difficult. It costs a lot of money, and I don't think people realize how much money it costs to start and run a network marketing company. You have to pay attorneys, infrastructure, IT, your product lines. You have to have a concept, branding, marketing. Can you tell me, and I hope you don't mind me asking, how you got the funds to start the company? Did you bring investors in, or is this something that you funded on your own?
Да, это тоже хороший вопрос.
That's a good question as well.
Для меня лично это очень важный вопрос.
For me personally, this question is really important.
Потому что лично я никогда бы не присоединился к компании, которая создана на привлеченные инвестиции.
Because for me, I would never myself join the company which was opened with the money loaned.
Я был в компании, которая привлекла огромные инвестиции.
I was in one company which was opened with the loaned money.
Именно это, наверное, и послужило тому, что правила игры поменялись.
And I believe this point changed the rules of game for the company.
В 20 лет, когда я покинул компанию,
when I was 20 years, when I left the company,
я начал заниматься продажей недвижимости в Испании.
I started selling apartments in Spain.
Это был 2008 год.
That was at 2008.
Год потрясающих возможностей.
Year of huge possibilities.
Я благодарен мировому финансовому кризису за тот подарок, за то счастье, которое я приобрел за целый год.
I'm deeply thankful for the worldwide crisis, which gave a lot of surprises.
Потому что во время кризиса делаются большие состояния.
Because during the crisis time, huge amount of money can be made.
2008 по 2009 год я заработал свой первый миллион евро. Мне был 21 год.
When I was 21, in year 2008 or 2009, I earned my first million.
В 22 я заработал еще 3.5.
When I was 22, I earned 2.5 more.
Но я не создавал компанию.
But I did not create the company at that time.
Конечно, в 24 года, когда я открыл компанию.
So by the time when I was 24, when I opened up a company,
у меня были свои собственные средства.
I had my own money.
Но деньги далеко не главный ключ для достижения успеха.
But money is not the top priority, is not the key to start the company.
Но без денег невозможно, без больших инвестиций невозможно сделать то, что сделали мы.
But without huge amount of money, with investment, you cannot do anything similar what we did.
Об этом спотыкаются многие лидеры, которые думают, что они смогут создать свою компанию, потому что у них есть своя структура.
Many people struggle because of that, when they think that they have the huge structure and they can manage that.
Особенно здесь, в Америке.
Especially here in America.
Здесь ты абсолютно прав, нужны огромные вложения.
And here you are absolutely right, Kauri, that you need to have huge investments in the company.
Адвокаты.
Lawyers.
Программное обеспечение.
IT department.
И огромное количество маркетинговых материалов.
A lot of marketing tools and materials.
Много денег.
A lot of money.
It is a lot, and I want to commend Sergey for having his own money. I think it's really important as a distributor to know that the owner of my company is not controlled by an investor group. Investor groups that control executive teams, they demand returns, and sometimes the executive teams cut corners. And we see this all the time, and most distributors don't really know about how this works. But I will say, if I had a choice to have one founder, one owner that I trusted, that put his own money into the company, you know they're going to take care of the company. So thank you for that. I'm going to move on to the third question, or the fourth question right here. Let's talk about your products. When I first got these products in the mail, I was amazed when I tasted them. They were absolutely delicious. And I really looked at it and I didn't know what to think because I've never seen a product like this. Can you tell us about the technology behind this product and why you brought this product to market?
Oh, это, наверное, очень важный момент.
So, I would say that this point is very important.
Я говорил о том, что наличие денег не играет главную роль для создания великой компании.
As I told before, that having money is not enough to create the great company.
Да, без денег невозможно открыть, создать большую компанию.
Of course, without having money, you cannot open up a huge company.
Но я, как вы уже поняли, сетевик.
And as far as you can understand, I am a networker myself.
Я хотел создать компанию, которая бы сразу привлекла к себе внимание.
I wanted to create the company which could pay attention on it.
Для этого нужен продукт, время которого пришло.
That's why I needed the product, the time of which has come.
Я не хотел быть бледной копией других компаний.
I didn't want to become the replica of any other company.
Мне не хотелось повторять успех других.
I didn't want to repeat the success of other companies.
В 21 веке нет проблемы произвести что-либо интересное.
In 21st century, it is not a problem to create something new.
Сегодня проблема продать.
Today the real problem is to sell it.
Но несмотря на это, я не хотел брать продукт и перепродавать.
Knowing that, I didn't want to take any product and to resell it.
Я понимал, что для того, чтобы стать великую, глобальную, масштабную компанию,
I understood that to create a huge global company,
нужно иметь свое собственное производство, свой собственный продукт.
I have to have my own factory.
И собственный продукт.
And my own product.
И мне повезло.
And I was lucky.
Я познакомился в 24 года.
When I was 24, I met
с уникальной технологией.
A very unique technology.
Технология называется Accumulate SA.
The name of the technology is Accumulate SA.
Когда я первый раз попробовал продукт, изготовленный по этой технологии,
when I first tried the product, which was produced with this technology,
я был поражен, как быстро он действует.
I was amazed how fast it starts working.
На тот момент я понял, что ничего подобного в мире нет, не только в MLM, просто в мире нет ничего подобного.
But by that time I understood that nothing like that existed in the world, not in the industry, but in the whole world.
Продукт, который работает здесь и сейчас.
The product which works right here, right now.
Очень быстро.
Very fast.
И более того, его можно сделать в виде леденцов.
And more than that, it can be produced in lozenges.
И это меня просто поразило.
It made me really amazing.
Я выкупил лабораторию, технологию.
So I bought the technology, the laboratory.
И стал ее владельцем.
And I became the owner.
Поэтому не спрашивайте, куда делись те разработчики.
So do not ask the question, where are the creators of the technology?
Я все равно не скажу.
I'm not going to tell.
Могу лишь открыть маленькую тайну.
I can give you a little secret.
Им сегодня очень много лет.
They are really old today.
Потому что люди разрабатывали ее больше 20 лет.
Because these people who created the technology, it took them more than 20 years.
Они европейцы.
They are Europeans.
Эту технологию я выкупил.
I bought this technology.
Поэтому все в одних руках.
So I have everything in my own hands.
Hey, I love that. That's so very important. So Sergey basically goes out and purchases your own manufacturing facility. Guys, just so you know, it's a 48,000 square foot manufacturing facility. He owns it and produces all of his own products there. I'm going to give you kind of a close up. This is a blister pack of some of the accumulate drops. And if I could tell a quick story, Sergey, because I know that I know a little bit about the product, so I'm going to tell the story. Botanicals are harvested. When the botanicals are harvested, they're put into this process where the fibers are loosened and the DNA is extracted from the plants, and they're implanted on these drops. They're also negatively ionized charged with the accumulate technology. So you have a very unique product. They can put different ingredients into different of these boxes, into these different drops. And you can see that there are different types with different names. And I like to say 15 drops, 15 different experiences, a really unique product. And one thing Sergey didn't mention, I'm going to mention, they're absolutely delicious. They taste really good. In fact, when you put it in, you want to take more and more and more. I went through one day, I had like 15, right? Just because they taste so good. So the delivery system is very unique. The technology is a category creator. And Sergey, as he mentioned, when he was 24 years old, he found this technology, he purchased it, and now he's bringing it to market. I'm going to move on to the next question. I'm going to ask you more of a personal question. Sergey, how did you meet your wife, Olga? And can you tell us a little bit about your family?
Это тоже произошло в сетевом маркетинге.
So, how I met Olga, that was in network marketing as well.
Она была моим дистрибьютором.
She was my distributor.
Но дело в том, что я человек системный и всегда работаю по системе.
And being a very systematic person and working with a system.
В той компании нельзя было иметь отношений, если ты заинтересован по маркетингу в человеке, то есть.
At that company where I worked, it was prohibited to have any kind of relationship between distributors if you are interested for that person to get profit in marketing.
Когда ее спонсор, мой дистрибьютор, знакомил меня со своей командой,
when her sponsor, my distributor, get us to know each other,
ты знаешь его, это Феликс.
You know this person, it's Felix.
Он познакомил, представил меня как почитающего спонсора.
He introduced me as his sponsor.
Мне очень понравилась одна девушка.
I really liked one girl.
Я не мог думать ни о чем, про презентацию.
And I couldn't think about anything else. I couldn't get any kind of presentation.
Потому что я пытался произвести еще большее впечатление на нее.
Because I really wanted to impress her.
Разумеется, как только закончилась презентация,
of course, when the presentation was over,
они все подписались.
They all signed in.
Я был счастлив, когда узнал, что она подписалась там на мой 8-й или 9-й уровень.
I was extremely happy when I found out that she was my 8th or 9th line.
И я не получал никакого бонуса, у меня не было заинтересованности по маркетингу.
So I didn't get any bonus from her. I didn't get anything from her according to the comp plan.
Ну да, я был где-то вышестоящим спонсором, но я мог уже за ней ухаживать.
Yes, I was somewhere her sponsor, but at the same time I could make a move on her.
Потом было большое событие в Москве на несколько тысяч человек.
After that, we had a huge event in Moscow for several thousand people.
Приехало несколько американцев, очень крутых, известных.
Few Americans came, very popular, very cool.
Они никто из молодежи не хотели ехать на это событие.
And none of the youngsters, they didn't want to go to this event.
Ну, я, разумеется, смотивировал, собрал целый автобус.
And I motivated all the young people to go there. I gathered the whole bus to go to Moscow.
Потому что моя цель была поближе познакомиться с Ольгой.
Because my aim was to get closer to Olga.
Разумеется, в этой поездке все и началось.
So that's when all started.
Thank you. I'm laughing because you guys truly are a network marketing family. I mean, literally, literally, you're a network marketing family. How many kids do you guys have? Do you mind me asking that?
Да, у меня трое детей.
Yeah, of course. We have three children.
Fantastic.
Двое последних родились в Америке.
And two younger of our children, they were born in America.
Будучи в активной работе построения бизнеса с APL.
Being very active in building APL company.
В прошлом году родилась дочка. Мы проводили большую академию, летнюю академию, почти два года назад.
Two years ago, my middle child was born, my daughter, when we were creating the event, which is known as Summer Academy here in the States.
Это событие, как остаться в живых или последний герой.
So this event is more like survivor show.
Люди ходили по углям.
People were working on fire.
Раскрою секрет. Не так, как у Энтони Робинсона. Маленькая кучка угольков холодных.
And I will tell you the secret. It is not like Anthony Robbins does the small part of fire when you walk on it, but we have a huge one.
Посмотрите видео. Там были дубовые угли. Огромная площадка.
You have to take a look at our video about this event. You will see how huge fire we had.
Люди ходили с крысами, ползали с тараканами.
The people were interacting with mice. They were taking the spiders. They had to bite them, to eat them, to find something in them.
Во время подготовки такого события Ольга была беременна дочкой.
And during this preparation of this academy, Olga was pregnant with our second child.
В положении уже с третьим ребенком, с моим сыном.
And when she was pregnant for the third time with my son,
мы готовили восьмилетие компании.
We were creating, we were preparing the eighth anniversary of the company.
Мы летали на сцене, мы сжигали, поджигали, разрезали.
We were flying on the stage, we set people on fire, we were cutting people.
Это восьмичасовое иллюзионное шоу с появлением вертолетов, мотоциклов и так далее.
It was an 8-hour illusion show with appearing the helicopters, motorcycles.
И Ольга, наш креативный директор, моя супруга, организовывала все это, будучи в положении.
And Olga, my wife, being the creative director of the company, she was preparing all these events when she was pregnant with our third child.
Я думаю, вы теперь понимаете, насколько ненормальная у нас семейка сетевая.
So now I believe you understand how crazy our networking family is.
I really love that story, and I love how the family was formed, network marketing, finding your wife in your organization. And you know, your story I really like because it talks about culture. To a lot of companies these days, there's no culture left. It's just about making money and selling products. When you took a look at APL Go, you can see, obviously, I don't know if people know this, but Sergey is a magician. That's what he does besides being a company owner. He's a very good magician. And so all of your events, Sergey, I've noticed are a lot of fun. I saw an event where you're dressed up in a theme period. It looked like from the 1400s. Could you tell us about some of the crazy things that you guys do besides walking on fire for your events? Because I think people really want to understand your culture.
Да, отчасти это еще одно наше преимущество.
Yes, that is one of the advantages our company have.
Потому что помимо денег людям нужно еще и зрелище.
Because for people to have money is not enough. They want to have the show as well.
Люди, взрослые, они хотят веселиться как дети.
Adults, they want to have fun like children.
Есть возможность, благодаря компании, вернуться в детство, переодеться в какие-то пиратские костюмы или средневековые.
And thanks to the company, they have this opportunity to dress up like a medieval man or woman, to dress up like pirates.
У нас были гангстерские, венецианские костюмы.
We have gangster parties, we have Venetian parties.
Но самое главное, что дистрибьюторы активно в этом участвуют и тоже шьют себе костюмы.
But what is more important that the distributors, they sew their own costumes. They go to the atelier to get the costumes for themselves.
I love it. I love it. Our guest today, Sergey Kulikov, owner and founder of APL Go. We're talking about culture, and I've always believed this. People come for the check. They stay because of the culture. And if you can create a great culture in your company, people will stay for a very long time. Let's talk about something else, another reason why people come. It's the compensation plan. When I took a look at this compensation plan, it was something I've never actually seen before. There's some components about it that are very, very unique. When I did my due diligence, I realized that this is a very high-paying compensation plan, not from a marketing standpoint, but the actual amount paid out to distributors versus sales is over 60%. And I know just from looking at the numbers, there are going to be a lot of people making a lot of money, those who are willing to go in and work hard. Who came up with this compensation plan, and what can you tell us about it, why you like it so much, Sergey?
Наверное, три вещи.
Probably I would talk about three things.
Первое, что любой новичок, даже без опыта, работает в продажах или в сетевом маркетинге.
The first thing which I like the most, that the person who has zero experience in sales or network marketing
может прийти и начать зарабатывать действительно достойные деньги.
He can come, he can join the company and start earning real money.
Вторая вещь.
The second point.
То, что мы выплачиваем самые большие проценты в этой индустрии.
That we are paying out the biggest percentage in the net in the industry.
Это значит, что большие лидеры,
this means that huge leaders,
настоящие звезды этой индустрии,
huge stars of the industry,
профессионалы,
professionals,
или просто люди, которые, у которых горят пятки и хотят действовать,
or people who are eager to start and work,
они будут зарабатывать очень большие деньги.
They will be earning huge amount of money.
Потому что если сравнить, сколько процентов получает любой лидер в своей команде от своей структуры.
Because if you compare to how many percentage does the distributor get in his company where he's working now?
И я спрашивал уже у сотни больших лидеров разных компаний.
And I asked this question to hundreds of leaders of many different huge companies.
Никто не назвал мне, что он получает от созданной структуры больше 5%.
None of them told me that they earn more than 5% of the structure created.
То есть они создают товарообороты в 500 тысяч, в 1 миллион долларов.
So they are creating the sales volume of 500,000 or even 1 million
долларов.
Dollars.
А получают всего 5%.
And they get from this amount only 5%.
Это, наверное, неплохо.
I wouldn't say that it is bad.
Но у меня другая цель.
But my aim is not like that.
Я создавал, как я уже говорил, компанию для людей.
As I mentioned before, I wanted to create the company for people.
Я хочу, чтобы в APL были самые большие выплаты.
And I want an APL company to have the greatest amount of paychecks.
Моя ближайшая цель — это 20 миллионеров.
My nearest goal is to have 20 millionaires.
20 человек, которые будут получать 1 миллион долларов в месяц.
20 people who will be earning 1 million per month.
И это мне нравится.
And I love that.
Маркетинг позволяет играючи зарабатывать это.
And our compensation plan allows you to earn this amount of money.
И третья вещь.
And the third thing which I like.
То, что этот маркетинг не похож ни на один из тех, которые вы знаете.
And that our compensation plan is not like any other you might know.
То же самое, что мы сделали с продуктом, создали новую категорию товара.
It is the same like we did with the product when we created the new category of the product.
Мы создали новую категорию маркетинга, Найнером.
We created the new category of the compensation plan, which we call Найнери.
И это уникальное сочетание всех известных маркетингов.
And this is a unique blend of lots of compensation plans.
И это действительно круто.
And this is really amazing.
Итого, мы можем предложить новичку.
So, what we can offer for a newcomer?
Лидеру.
For the leader.
И даже клиентам.
And even for the customers.
То есть мы берем все категории.
We are taking all different spheres of the clients.
Вот чем мне нравится наш маркетинг.
That's why I like our compensation plan.
I love that explanation, and I'm going to give you an opinion. I'm going to talk a little bit more about the compensation plan. The most important part of the comp plan, in my opinion, is the product line. If you have a good product line, it's well-priced, and people like it, it'll power the comp plan. Number two, the comp plan you're describing is a 9 or 8. So what folks at home, just if this is a new term for you, the front end is a group bonus that you can actually build out 9 legs wide. There's a check match on those legs as well. It's really, really, really unique. The back end is a unilevel where you get paid without any structural requirements on levels 1 to 6. From level 7 on, there's a infinity bonus. And there's actually about 8 other bonuses embedded in this compensation plan. Again, it starts with really great products at prices that people can afford. So I want to invite you, apogo.us. If you're watching this video, go to the website, take a look at the products. You can do your research about them. You can get a little bit of understanding about the compensation plan, about the company. APOGO is set up for success. They've got global offices, warehouses. You put your order in, you get your tracking number the next day. It's really great and simple. And the products are absolutely amazing. We're going to close this off. I want to thank Sergey. And as we leave, before we leave this conversation, Sergey, is there anything else you'd like to share with us? Any parting words before we end this interview?
Самая основная мысль – не теряйте время.
So the main thing I would like to tell you – do not waste your time.
Наверное, время никогда не было так важно, как сейчас.
I believe time was never as important as it is now.
Я не упустил момент 2008.
I didn't waste my time in 2008.
Сегодня кризис пострашнее 2008.
Today's crisis is even worse when it was in 2008.
Огромное количество людей осталось без работы.
A lot of people are now unemployed.
И люди, которые еще 2 месяца назад не хотели ничего слышать о дополнительных возможностях.
And people who didn't want to hear anything about additional income 2 months ago.
Сегодня ждут нашего предложения.
They are waiting for our offer.
Потому что в индустрии сетевого маркетинга.
Because in network marketing industry.
Давно не происходило ничего глобального.
There was nothing global like that.
Я думаю, что время APL пришло.
And I believe that APL time has come.
Я могу лишь гарантировать, что каждый, кто присоединится к нашей семье,
and what I can guarantee to you, each person who joins our family,
никогда не пожалеет о сделанном выборе,
will never regret about the choice he made.
Я буду счастлив отслеживать успех каждого.
I will be more than happy to follow your success.
Сегодня все только начинается.
Today we are only at the beginning.
Sergey, спасибо. Thank you so much. Anna, thank you for interpreting for us. Again, if you're watching this video for the very first time, contact whoever sent you this link. APOGO is in whisper launch phase in the United States. We have a lot of steam. We have a lot of early interest. There are some really good leaders taking a look at us and joining us today. Again, you have an advantage to get in early. And as Sergey mentioned, we live in a difficult time. So let's go ahead and find people who need help. Who want financial freedom, who want time freedom, not just to survive, but to thrive. That's what we want to do. So to finish this off, thanks for joining us again. Thank you, Sergey. Thank you, Anna. We'll be posting this video on YouTube. Have a great one. And until next time, APO, go. Let's go. Take care, everyone.
So, спасибо. Bye.
Thank you. Bye.